to today's lecture. Today we want to look at the Gaussian elimination method for solving a system of equations. Gaussian elimination method for solving a system of equations. Now, to understand this, let's look at a question. In the course of solving the question, all the concepts you need to know to really understand this will be given to you. Let's look at the question like this. Question one. Let's assume that I have been given the system of equations. A plus B plus C is equal to 3. Then A plus 2B plus 3C is equal to 4. And then A plus 4B plus 9C is equal to 6. Let's assume that we have this system of equations to solve using the Gaussian elimination method. So it means that I want to solve for the value of A, B, and then C. Now, to do this, so solution. So this is a question that I have been given to solve. So solution. Now what you do is that if you're able to get a matrix for this. So in matrix form, you're going to have something like this. You are looking at the coefficients of A, B, and C here. So the coefficient of A is 1, the coefficient of B is 1, the coefficient of C is 1. That is for the first equation. The second one, the coefficient of A is 1. The next one is of B is 2, and then this one is 3. And then we have 1, 4, 9. So this will be a matrix. Now, what this means is that we are going to have, this is A, this is a matrix, and then the whole of this will be A, B, C. And this is equal to 3, 4, 6. This is the question. Yes. So, in fact, you can just see that the whole of this, you can see that it's less in matrix A. And the whole of this is X. And this is equal to, say, B. So this is the system we are solving. A, X is equal to B. So you want to solve for X. So you, in this case, you want to solve for the values of A, B, and C. Now, how do you use the Gaussian elimination method to solve this? So let's continue from here. To solve this, what you normally do is that you try to get what you call an augmented matrix. So I'm going to have something like this. The augmented matrix will be something like this. You have this 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3. Then we write this one. 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 4, 9. That is the matrix, the bigger matrix. And then you try to do something like this. And then bring in the right hand side, the values, the B values. That is 3, 4, 6. So this will be the augmented matrix. Now, what you are going to do is this. To use the Gaussian elimination method, what you are going to do is that you are going to work on the left hand side here, this matrix. You are going to work on this to change this 1 to 0, this to 0, this to 0, this 1 to 1, and then this 1 to 1. If you are able to do that, then whatever will be left here will be the solution to the problem. So let's look at it. Now, to do this, we use what you call elementary rule operations. Elementary rule operations to do this. So first of all, this one is already 1. This is 1, so you touch it. This one should be 0, this should be 0, this should be 0. And then this should be 1, this one should also be 1. Yes. In other words, you want to transform the left-hand side into an upper triangular matrix. Right? This will be 0, this one will be 0, this one also be 0. Okay. So let's do that. So how do you go about this? So to do this, rule 2, you can say that root 2 minus root 1 should give us root 2. The junior elementary equation. We want to cause this one to go to 0. So root 2 minus root 1 should give us root 2. Now this one should also go to 0, so you can do it. So come on. And then you're also saying that root 3 minus root 1 should give us root 3. So let's apply the operations. When you apply the operations, you're going to get this. You are going to get, because the root 1 has not been typed, we have 1, 1, 1, this way, 3. Now let's go move on to row 2. Row 2, we are saying that to get row 2, you should subtract row 1 from it. So this is row 2. 1 minus 1, 0. 2 minus 1, 1. 3 minus 1, 2. And then 4 minus 3 is 1. That is row 2. Now row 3, to get row 3, we are saying that you should subtract row 1 from row 3. So this is row 3. So 1 minus 1, 0. 4 minus 1, 3. 9 minus 1, 8. And then 6 minus 3, 3. So we are done with the row operations. Yes, these two row operations. Now, at this point, look on the board. We want to cause this is 0, this is 0. We want to cause this one to go to 0. This one to go to 0. So what do you do? I want to call this one to go to 0. So you can see that we can decide to multiply this one by 3 and subtract from this. So because of that, you can see that root 3 minus 3 root 2, because this is 3, I want to call this one to 0. So if the 3 minus 2 root 2, this one goes to 0. So when you are working on this one, you should apply to all the elements in that row. So this is a decision you are taking. So this is giving us root 3. Now if you do this, then this will be the resulting matrix. So when you have something like this, the root 1 has not been typed, so we are not working on that one. So let's repeat the numbers there. 3. Now the row 2, I'm not going to touch it, so let's repeat the numbers there. Now row 3. We are saying that to get row 3, so row 3 minus 3 row 2, so look at it. This is row 3 minus 3 times row 2. So 3 times 0 will be 0. When you subtract from this, you're getting 0. Now let's look at this one. 3, that is in row 3, minus 3 times the number, this number 1. So 3 times 1 will be 3. So when you subtract from this 3, you are going to get 0. Are you seeing it? 3 minus, like 3 minus 3 times 1 here. And that will give us 0. Now the next one will be 8, which is in row 3, minus 3 times 2. This is 8 minus 6. And that is 2. This one is 2. The last one, I think we have 3 minus 3 times 1. And this one will be 3 minus 3, which is 0. So we have it this way. Yes, we have it this way. Now, you have been able to reduce the left-hand side, or transform the left-hand side into an upper triangular matrix. What this means is that these are zeros, and these are non-zeros. Look at it. So you have it this way. Even at this point, you can decide to use back substitution to find the values of A, B, and C. But it is advisable to reduce, if it is possible, yes, to reduce this one also to 1. And when you are able to reduce this one to 1, we say that the problem has been reduced to rho echelon form. Rho echelon form. That would mean that this one is also 1. Yes, this one is also 1. And so if you're able to do that, you see that this part has been transformed into rho echelon form. Yes, so let's quickly do that. Now, this one is 2. You want to make it 1. So if you want to make it 1, let me clear this side and continue from here. If you want to make it 1, then you can take this decision. You can just say that R3 should give you R3. Isn't it? You want to make it 1-1, so you have to divide 2 by 2. And the same as multiplying by half. So when you do that, it means that you are going to have something like this. The first row has not been typed, so you have to repeat the numbers. 3, and then 0, 1, 2, 1. And then the last one, you are saying that you are dividing 2 by 2, or you are multiplying 2 by half. 0 times half is 0, 0 times half is 0. 1 over 2 times 2 is 1, and then 0 times half, or 1 over 2 times 0 is 0. So you have it this way. So in this case, we have been able to, so it means that we have been able to reduce the left hand side, or we have been able to transform the left hand side into rho echelon form. Look at it. So these are zeros, and this 1, 1, 1. Now, having obtained this, we are going to use back substitution to find the values of A, B, and C. Now look on the board. You see, we are solving for A, B, and C. And this is what it means. So it means that this one is A, B, C. This column is for A, B, and C. So what this means is that from this, you should be able to come out with new equations. And the new equations should be like this. Let's start from the first one. The first one will be A times 1, so it will be A plus B plus C. Look at it. B plus equal to 3. And then the next one, because this one is 0, it will be 0 times A, which is 0. And then B times 1. So this one will be B plus 2C is equal to 1. We are getting equations from this one. And then the last one, this one is 0. 0 times A will be 0. This times this will be 0. So 1 times C is C. So C is equal to 0. Now, if C is equal to 0, then the values of A and B can easily be obtained. So we call this one back substitution. So C is equal to 0. So if C is equal to 0, then from here, you can say that B plus C, 2C, so let me call this one maybe 1, 2, 3. This is, so you can say from 2, B plus 2C is equal to 1. So B plus 2C is 0 is equal to 1. So it will be B plus 0 is equal to 1. This means that B is equal to 1. B is equal to 1. Now, if B is equal to 1, C is equal to 0, from 1, so from 1, equation 1, we can say that A plus B plus C is equal to 3. So A plus the B is 1, the C is 0, equal to 3. So what this means is that A is equal to 3 minus 1, and it is equal to 2. Isn't it? So therefore, A is equal to 2, B is equal to 1, and C is equal to 0. So this will be the solution of the problem. A is equal to 2, B is equal to 1, and C is equal to 0. So basically, this is how the Gaussian elimination method works. First of all, try to get an augmented matrix by bringing the right-hand side value. By fusing the matrix with the right hand side value and use elementary row equations to ensure that the left hand side has been reduced to rho echelon form, and then use back substitution to obtain the values. It is not difficult at all. Even at this point, you could have still used a back substitution method to obtain it, but it is safer this way. Thank you very much, viewers, for your attention. For more of this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, Shamalaa Jnr. Thank you very much.